Now we shall discuss exercise 4.1. See the first question. Use the figure to name. This type of figure is given in your book. And they are asking first to find out, name the 5 points. The first question is to find out the 5 points. Now what are points? We have discussed in the last video. That is the location, a dot. So see, you have this dot. So many you have. You have D, then you have point E, correct? Then this is a comma. One more you can take, point O. Then you take point C, 1, 2, 3, 4. And the rest, last one is point 5. So we see the 5 points. Now they are saying in the second question that name a line. Look up, children. A line. See, one is line and one is line segment. A line, you will see, it will be extended from both the sides. Just see, if you say D and O, this is wrong because see, D and O, it is a ray. We want D and B. Okay, so you can take one line like this, D and B. Furthermore, if you say, see, there are many other points also, but this line is starting from D. I am taking this line, D and B. Now, the third one is, you are asked to write down the names of 4 rays. 4 rays is easy. See, a ray, it starts from certain point. It has a source point and it will extend endlessly only from one side. So we can see like this, it is OC. So answer for this, you write down this much, then 4 rays, and below this you will write, you have to first show, children, you draw this. You have seen this OC. OC, this is one ray. Then you can label this, nothing is given, you can label this is also a ray. You can label this as O and this is A. If suppose here no name is given, you leave. We can have, see, OB also. O and B, it is also a ray. O, B, from here you can take any. See, O, D. Why, children? See, this is an extension. That means maybe the line must have started like this. OE, then extend it like this. So you can take from here both OE, OD. Is it clear? So you can take like this O, and suppose it started with E. So OE. Now for a line we know, or for a ray, from one side it can extend. So if it is extended, what will this become? This will become O. On extension, you will see here D. So this is ray. So first you draw and then write down O, C. See, when we are labeling, then also remember to put the symbols above the names. So O, C, then we have O, A, then we have O, B, then O, E, then we have O, D. 4 they are asking. So you write down any 4. Then you have 5 line segments. Line segments. That is, see here. DE. Let us understand what is a line segment. Where it has a definite length. DE. See, it starts from here and ends here. Or you can say ED. It is E starting from E and finishes at D. So we have DE. Wherever it will look like this, that is a line. Then EO also, check. It is starting from O and here also you have a point. So it is a line segment. Same way, we have OC as a line segment. Is it clear? Or you can take OE, OD. Yes, we have taken. You can take OD also. 3 are asked. You will not take C, it is a ray. So you will take OD. You can take that also. 5 you are asking. So here it is. See. See, see, here you have a dot. That means here you have one point. So very well, we see that it has a starting point from O, and here there is a fixed length. Here is point C, correct? But as such, if you say, ma'am, here, then you are writing it for ray also. Yes, we can do that. Because see the arrow, you can extend from this side. That is also true. So OC is also your ray. So this is the solution of first question. Question number 2, they are saying that name the line given in all possible ways. In how many ways they are asking? 12 ways. They have just given us one line. A diagram of a line is given with few points on that. And they are asking to name this in 12 ways using only 2 letters. So line, you see, this is a line. So you can write down A, B, correct? Then you can move to A, C. Why, children? Because see, it is a line. It gets extended. Don't get confused, ma'am. Only C, D we will take or only A, B we will take. No. You can take A, B, A, C, A, D. Because maybe suppose it started from A and B. But because it is a line, that means it can get extended. It can move endlessly from both the directions. So, if it moves in a straight line like this, so now you have point C. That is also a line. That is why starting from A, AB is one line, AC is one line, and AD is also one line. Then, if we take now B as center, BA is one line, correct? Same way, you will see BC is also one line and BD is also one line. Now, let us start from C. If we start from C, then you just suggest how many lines you can see from here. CB can be one line. Yes, it can move from this direction. Then maybe after CB they have extended to this side. And now we have CA as another line. Same way CD is also one line. Now if we talk about D, suppose we say the line is starting from D. So this is one point D and from D one point is C. Because maybe this was a line, then they must have extended. Now it is D, B. Now it is D, A. So we have written it in 12 ways. This is our question number 2. Now one more question we will discuss. That is the fourth question. It is very interesting. They are saying that how many lines can pass through one point? That means, children, see, I have one point, one dot. Through this, how many lines can pass? See, I will pass one. Oh, sorry. So, let us see from one point, how many lines we can pass through it. So, see, this is one line. I am passing through this point. Okay. Same way, I can pass through this point another line. It is allowing me, see, I can pass as many lines. Just take it like this. This is wrong, huh? It has to pass through the point. So, like this. You want. This is correct. See, how many like this, children? You have a line, you have a dot, you have a point. Now, if I ask you, just keep on crossing this point. How many times you can do that? Infinite times. You can do that many times, so many times. So answer is many times. Infinite lines can be passed through a given point, one point. But now see the next thing. The next part of the fourth question is that if you have been given 2 points, let me rub. See, they have asked us that if you have 1 point, how many lines you can pass through it? Many lines. But they are saying now if you have given, see here. Now they are saying that if you have 2 points, now tell us how many lines can be drawn through these 2 points. Let us try. I will start from here. I try from here, but I am not able to pass through both the lines. So if I have to pass through both the lines, in that case, how many times I can do? Only one time. From two given points, only one line can be passed through it. Try again. Let me start from here. If I start from here like this, then also I will be passing through one given point. Two points, I will not be able to pass through it. So the answer for this is that when two points are given, only one line can be drawn or passed through it. Okay. Now see children, question number 3. Use the figure to name line containing point E. See, I am explaining this, you will try it on your own. I will give you some hints to solve. There is one diagram given here. Here is your point E. This is your F. Same way, here it is O. Here you have D. Then you have B. Through B, one line is again crossing. That is point O. And here you have point C. And one point is A. Look at the question. The first is, name the line containing point E. Which line contains point E? We can see here. First is answer is C. E. Just bring your pencil, put it at point E and see lines. Check the lines. One is this. That is, this is your FE. Correct? Then is it only FE? Can you see here one more line is C? So this is also through E. Where it is going? To D. So DE is one more. If they are saying, here it is not mentioned how many. But if it is given many or more than 3 or 4, you can write down E, B also. Yes? So there are many options for you. Now the same thing, line passing through A. Tell children, passing through A, which line is passing through A? Through this point A, you can see it's B, it's D. So you can have again many options. Use your choice. Because it is not giving how many points or how many lines they want. Now, line on which O lies. Where is O? Okay. Here is O. On this is a line. Which line you can see where O lies? That is CBO. So you can write down. Draw that figure first. C. It is B and O. And you can write down. Here it is not given any letter. How many letters? You can write down C, O as one line. Now, two pairs of intersecting lines. Just see. Intersecting line means that when you have one line and you make the other line pass through it, it will cross that line, meet at some point. So, intersecting point, check here B. So, which line is this? This is CO and O A. B you can say, A, D you can say. Then the second pair, see again, this is one line, AE. And from this, you can see, FE is the intersecting. It is passing through EA. See, you have EA and from here you have FE. And E is the point of intersection. So we have these two pairs. One is CO and AE. The other is EA and FE. So this was your third question. Now, for third question almost I have explained you. Please try children, question number 5. And try to solve it on your own. And send me it on Google Class. That's all. Try these questions.